Today we're going to look at how to make a heat map in FileMaker. You can see here I have a demo file with a heat map of some of the United States, and the colors of these states are controlled with these data fields over here on the right. So for example, I could bump up Indiana to 30%, and you would see it changes color, and I could go all the way on up to my 100% color. All the other states are similarly affected, and you can change them with these corresponding field on the right. You could take this to the entire United States, but for the sake of today, I'm just going to demo with these. So let's get into how this works. The crux behind this is the FileMaker 14 custom button icon. If you add a button in FileMaker 14, you can select a button, and you can add your own custom shape. So in this case, I've added shapes for all of the states that I need, and I have these custom icons available to download on our website, along with my article. The main trick here is just getting the size and positioning right, so you can use the inspector to get exact positioning to make sure all your states are flush with each other, or you can leave a little gap between them, however you prefer to do it. There is a limitation here as far as size goes, because FileMaker only allows you to get up to 128 points, and that's the max. So your largest state will have to be, it will set the limitation of the other states. The workaround to this is you could cut your state into quarters and then just kind of position them so that the user can't tell that there's four different ones, and then that way you could have a larger component next to smaller components without the smaller components being too small to use. So the next thing that I have here is I have this hover effect. Let's go back into browse mode. I have this hover effect here, and the way I did that is I actually had to create a second layer of a map, because the hover state in FileMaker is overridden by the conditional formatting. Conditional formatting is what we're using to change the colors, and so therefore I had to make my own hover state, which I'll show here. Let's see. If I take these three, you see they have a transparent hover state, which just kind of overlays over the other map and indicates to the user that they could click on it. So you could use this for something like drilling into a report or whatnot. You don't have to do this. It does add complexity to the layout and makes it hard to drill down to the states beneath and modify the conditional formatting, but it is a kind of a neat effect for the user. The downside to using this is if you do split your SVG into quarters, your hover object is not going to hover all four sections at the same time, even if you group them as a button. So just keep that in mind, and if you're going to be quartering the SVGs, probably don't want to make a hover state. It's totally doable to do without a hover state, and on top of that, you could also make these buttons popover buttons with your custom SVG attached. Let's get into the conditional formatting and see how that works. I'm going to go into this one. You can set conditional formatting on a button, and you can actually conditionally format the icon color now in FileMaker 14. So what you're going to want to do is set up your data points and assign them each their own color over here. You see I have one for these six. Do be careful if you go beyond seven different colors on your key, it's going to get confusing to read your map, and it's also going to make your key hard to read. So the important thing here is that I ordered my conditional formatting in the way that I want them to fire. FileMaker will go through them top to bottom. So it'll evaluate this one, then the next one, then the next one, the next one. And this is the last one that will override the rest if it's true. So you don't want to put a small value at the bottom, because then it will always be overriding the greater values. The other thing you can do is you can consider not using the same logic I'm using, and you could kind of put them in any way you wanted if you used, for example, another function to just say, you know, also greater than, like greater than zero but less than 20, then you could organize them however you wanted, but just keep that in mind. So that's it. all you have to do after that is save your layout. I'm actually going to revert mine. Save your layout and your heat map is ready to go. You can use this for more than just a heat map. You could make kind of any custom chart you can dream up. You could map components of a car or other mechanical object. You could show health data on a human body. You could kind of do anything your imagination. You can come up with in your imagination. You just need to create the SVGs in a vector graphics image editor like Adobe Illustrator, and you're good to go. Thanks for watching.